Hi, welcome to Easy Learning Economics. I am Dr. Kaval Talreja, PhD in Economics. Today, our topic is Oligopoly, Contestable Market. As we know that the oligopoly has a different forms, contestable market, or collusive market, or the price leadership, or tacit collusion, or the cartel or ring arrangement. So here we are going to discuss only the oligopoly, contestable market, in which we discuss that what is the oligopoly, what are the features of oligopoly, what is duopoly, what are the advantages of oligopoly, what are the disadvantages of oligopoly, and what is contestable markets, contestable market conclusion. So these are the lecture contents for today lecture. So here I would like to suggest my two videos that are beneficial for you. If you go through the monopoly price and output determination in the short run and long run period, my video number 48, equilibrium of firm under monopolistic competition in short run and long run period. These two videos, monopoly and monopolistic competition, are also a form of imperfect market, and they also relate with the oligopoly. That's why you must go through these videos. Exam notes on economic related topics, you can visit my website, that easylearningeconomicsblogspot.com. So links are given in description box, and you will find the exam note from exam point of view. Here we start that what is the definition of oligopoly. Oligopoly is a form of imperfect market in which number of firms are more than 2 but less than 20, selling substitute goods and are interdependent on each other. The oligopoly form of market is defined by the behavior of firm in the market. The oligopoly is said to exist when top 5 firms get 60% of total market share. It means few firms has high concentration ratio. Airline market, car makers, mobile companies, oil and gold producers, consultancy profession dominated by big 4 firms are examples of oligopoly market. Now we are talking about the features of oligopoly. So what are the characteristics or features of oligopoly? That few large firms with high market share or dominance in the market. Each firm deals in brand product. Form of oligopoly like competitive price leadership or tacit collusion or cartel arrangement is recognized through the behavior of firm. Firms may cooperate with each other and agree on mutual price and output decision, or they might divide the market among themselves under collusive arrangements. High barriers to entry and exit from market do exist. Cross elasticity of demand is so high, so each firm price policy affects other, and every seller is aware about the action of others. Demand curve for firms product might have different behavior with changes in price. In order to increase the volume of sale by attracting the consumers, oligopolists do engage in advertising and other sales promotional activities. Consumers don't have perfect knowledge. Goods are close substitutes. Goods may be homogeneous or heterogeneous product, like petrol, steel, cement, zinc, copper are homogeneous, while cars, cigarettes, electronic equipments are different product. So oligopolists charge high price than competitive market. Competing firms merge with other firms in order to have more control over supply. An industry in which there are only 2 dominant firms is called duopoly. Advantages of oligopoly. Oligopoly may agree on one price. Oligopolists may earn economic profit. In the long run period, the oligopolists earn more than standard profit. Stability of price is observed under collusive arrangement. Customers can easily compare the price. So now we are going to discuss what are the disadvantages of oligopoly. As far as disadvantages of oligopoly are concerned, that the price is determined under mutual collusive agreement reduces the consumer surplus and provide disadvantage to consumer. As we know that the consumer surplus is the difference between the market price and demand price. Market price is the price at which the commodity is sold in market, whereas the demand price is the price which a consumer is willing to pay. So the price determined under mutual collusive agreement reduces the consumer surplus. Firms make good profit and could fail to announce the incentives for product innovation. Price war is possible under a competitive situation of oligopoly. What is contestable markets? The concept of contestable market was given by William J. Baumol in his theory in the year 1982. He stated that the firm under competitive condition charges that price which is settled through the demand and supply forces and yields competitive equilibrium due to continuous threat of new entrant. Under contestable form of market oligopoly, firm behavior is much like monopoly. An oligopoly charges high price and maximize profit where marginal revenue is equal to marginal cost. Few rival firms compete with each other when new firms can enter into market while facing little barriers. The continuous entrance of new firms causes the firms to focus on sale volume rather than profit. In these situations, the firm can enter and leave freely with low sunk cost. There is continuous threat that new companies can enter into the market and compete with existing firms. Economic profit of firm is converted into normal profit due to the fear about entry of new firms. Here you can see a graph. The output is shown on x-axis, whereas the price is shown on y-axis. The supernormal profit firm is earning. If the firm charges the price P1, that would encourage the new customers to enter into a market to earn economic profit. And if the firm decreases the price and charges the P2, that the new firm will not enter into market. It is contestable market that threat of entry keeps price at P2. If the existing firm charges the price P1, new firm would be encouraged to enter into the market and could earn economic profit. In order to discourage the new entrant, the existing firm charges price P2 rather than P1 and produces Q2 output rather than Q1. At this price, no new firm is willing to enter into the market as the firm earns normal profit. So, what is the conclusion about the contestable market form of oligopoly? So, we may conclude that the firm in the contestable market may make or close to or only normal profit. Inefficient firm cannot survive in the market as they can't keep price low enough to prevent entry into the market. If the new firms entering into market with high cost, then firm will fail and they have to quit from the market. It is the only threat of new firm that keeps the contestable market competitive. So it is all about the oligopoly, duopoly and contestable form of oligopoly. In the first part we discussed the contestable market or the contestable form of oligopoly, while in the second part we discuss the collusive or tacit collusion, whereas in the third part of oligopoly we shall discuss the cartel arrangement. So if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and let me know in comment box if you have any feedback. Thanks for watching.